So how'd it go last night, you and that perfume sales girl? She was fine.
Yeah, she smelled good, too. Everything was going great until Alicia came between us.
Alicia? You had two of them in there and didn't tell me?
No, I wish. I'm talking about Alicia, my tattoo. And this thing's been on my shoulder ever since that Christmas party 2 years ago when I single-handedly put the yak in cognac.
So it was only one woman. Then why are we having this conversation?
Well, hell, it's like having a third party present. Man, every time a woman sees this tattoo, the inquisition starts. Who, what, why, when? Believe me, Ed, who, what, why, when is not my idea of pillow talk.
Live and you learn, Malcolm.
It's the dumbest thing you've ever done for a female.
You know, I really don't like to talk about it. I mean, let's just say it's a good thing hair grows back.
They just won't leave you alone while you're sitting inside your home.
Found a brother who can disguise my Alicia tattoo into something else. What do you think?
I like the mermaid.
Me too. See, there's a certain je ne sais quoi that has an almost mythical appeal. And she's not wearing a shirt.
Hey, don't get excited, fellas. This is a 90s mermaid. There's no guarantee that that's all her.
Well, Mal, have you considered laser surgery? It's painless and it works.
How much does it cost?
About $2,000.
I thought you said it was painless.
Hey, I could take your tattoo off for 50 bucks. I got a bottle of tequila and a belt sander over in the garage.
Hey, what would you say if I could get one of the doctors down in the hospital to remove your tattoo for free?
I'd say thank you very much, except nothing comes for free. What do you expect in return?
Well, you heard me mention my baby sister, Claudine. The fairest blossom on our family tree.
The research chemist, that fairest blossom?
Precisely. Anyway, she was just named Employee of the Month down at the pharmaceutical laboratory where she works. But sadly, she has no one to celebrate with but me.
So what are you suggesting, that she should celebrate with me?
Oh, please, Malcolm, I have the doctor throwing a lower GI for free.
No, Tim, look, you tell your sister I said congratulations, but blind dates are one thing I don't do.
You and me both. Tell her I can't make it either.
Okay. Ma'am, are you sure?
Hey, Tim, your next oil change, $4,000.
Now, would you reconsider? I could arrange a limousine. The funeral home still owes me a credit. Grandma pulled through.
All right, well, she is Employee of the Month, you're a friend, and your bar tab is paid up. All right, I'll take Claudine out.
Claudine? Who, why, where, and what is Claudine? Explain.
Simone, I thought you worked this out in therapy. Claudine is Tim's sister. I'm doing him a favor, and it's not a date.
Oh, well, in that case, you just have a good time, okay?
Hey, and just to make sure Claudine knows it's not a date, we're all going. So, Claudine, you're your laboratory's Employee of the Month. Huh? You must be proud.
Well, my competition was a guy who washes the test tubes in a diabetic rat. Who wouldn't be proud?
Well, you look nice. Can't say that about the diabetic rat.
You know, I took chemistry in high school.
Oh, I find that hard to believe.
Did I take chemistry?
No, that you went to high school.
Look, sis.
Oh, look, it's just a scam. He and I often step to the wee hours discussing the profound mysteries of the universe. Does God exist? And if he does, why does he put nipples on men?
I've never met this man before in my life.
What's with the hat?
What's with your mouth?
No, come on, everybody. I mean, look, we're in a limo, we're on our way to the Cobra Club, the hottest night spot in Kansas City. I mean, what do we have to complain about?
Well, I'm extremely prone to motion sickness if you're, you know, waiting for someone to get the ball rolling.
Do you eat?
See, that right there is something like the attitude that I was thinking that we might be better off without.
I can defend myself, Nicolette.
Oh, now I'm the enemy?
Ladies, ladies, come on, this is supposed to be fun. You know, fun, fun, fun. This is Claudine's special night. And I, for one, am honored to be in the presence of such incomparable wit, unmatched beauty, and employee of the month intelligence.
Did you bring your Dramamine? Now I'm gonna be sick.
Listen, Ed, do me a favor. Please don't leave me alone with her for 1 second.
Claudine, these two gentlemen would like to know if you and I would care to dance.
Oh, no thanks, fellas, but feel free to dance with each other. Looks to me like you'd enjoy that more anyway.
That wasn't very smart. And even if you're right, they make the best dancers.
I'd be happy to bust a move or two with you, Nicolette.
You probably bust more than that, but I do want to dance. Come on, you too, Simone. This is a story you can tell your grandchildren.
Oh, no, I don't really dance.
Oh, great. Well, you can sit here and chat with Claudine.
Oh, on second thought, come here, big boy.
Listen, I'm gonna make a trip over to the bar. Can I buy you a drink?
Can I buy you a drink? Would you like to come back to my place? I promise I'll call you. And then you don't.
So nothing for you then. Okay. Excuse us. And this woman is awful. Employee of the month? Sight unseen, I would have voted for the diabetic rat.
Look, we're supposed to do our job, make her happy. Now she's happy making everybody else miserable, so let's get out of here.
No, I can't. See, the doctor is removing my tattoo in stages. If we leave now, Tim's gonna be mad, and I will be stuck with A and L on my shoulder for the rest of my life.
Let me get this straight. Right now, you got a tattoo that says Al. I mean, here's a radical thought. How about paying to get the damn thing removed?
Oh, Ed, McGee's do not pay for what they can get for free. In fact, my grandfather has a tattoo on his bicep which says that.
So what are we supposed to do, man? This woman's tough.
In your dreams.
As nails.
And nobody can get through to her, not even you, Mac Daddy Player of the Year.
Well, I don't feel comfortable being the one to say it, but if I wanted to get through to her, I could get through to her.
Yeah, if that's what you need to get you to sleep at night.
I don't need that to get to sleep at night. I just happen to know what I know.
I just happen to doubt what I doubt.
So it's like that. All right, brother man, you stand back, enjoy your drink, and observe as your doubt is erased and another chapter is written in the legend, which is I. Claudine, you ever get the feeling that the world was suddenly good, that life had meaning, that your five senses were never enough to take in all the joy?
Every morning when I see the bacterial growth in my petri dish.
Yeah, that's the feeling I'm talking about. See, that's the feeling you give me.
So, I'm your bacterial growth?
In the best and highest way.
Tell me something, Malcolm. How many times have you used this five senses line on a girl?
Okay, you got me. That was the 73rd, but the first time I meant it. And it's the first time bacteria ever came up.
Careful. You keep talking like that, you might just get what you're after.
So, am I close to breaking down the hydrocarbonic polymer which surrounds your, heart?
No, you're not getting close. You're there, big boy.
Just getting home. Last time I saw you, you were with that Asian girl.
Yeah, we kicked it. Man, you got to know, man. Having a limo is sometimes better than having a personality. How'd you get with old Claudine?
No, I didn't get rid of Claudine. I mean, that's a woman with sensitivity and dignity, man. I faked food poisoning.
Malcolm, I need to talk to you about my sister.
What? No hello?
No hello, and this doesn't concern you.
I can live with that.
Tim, what about your sister?
Did you seduce her?
Did you want me to seduce her?
No, I wanted you to show her a good time. Not a good time.
Tim, this still don't concern me, right?
Right.
Just checking. Proceed.
Malcolm, Claudine told me you love her. Now, do you really love her?
Oh, Tim, love is such an elusive term. You know, in fact, in France, they have 25 different words for the word love.
Yet not one for deodorant.
Listen, my sister's heart's not made of stone. And if she sheds one tear, just one, over you, that tattoo on your shoulder, Al, stays. But Tim is gone forever. Do you hear me? Forever. Forever. Forever.
He was serious. Whenever that big fella start getting redundant, he's serious.
What am I supposed to do, man? I have to break it off with Tim's sister without hurting her feelings. Without hurting her delicate feelings. Claudine, quick, come in. I don't want fresh air to sneak in.
I didn't know you smoked.
Smoke? I do more than smoke. I'm addicted to this stuff. I go through about 20 of these a day.
Malcolm, I had no idea.
Well, you know, it's better you found out now. And I understand if you walk out that door and you never want to see me again, no hard feelings. Have a nice life.
No. I mean, I had no idea we had this much in common. Take a puff of this baby. Natural leaf hand-rolled Cohiba. My dog groomer smuggles them in from Canada. Take. Be right back.
Where you going?
To the car. I keep a humidor in the trunk.
I'll be right with you, baby. Put on the Joy Luck Club.
All right. What else have you got?
My Aunt Clara, she left Uncle James, you know what I'm saying? Because he used to take her on hunting trips.
Okay. I see killing a deer can kill any romance.
Deer? Please, ain't got nothing to do with a deer. She had on a fur coat. He mistaked her and winged her in the shoulder, spun her around. That marriage didn't have a chance.
Your 3 a.m. wake-up call. I'm ready. How about you? Where's your stuff?
Oh, no, I'm not going. You see, the McGees are like lions. The women go out and hunt while the guys stay home. But here, blow on this softly at the edge of the creek. It makes the sound of a female bullfrog in heat. It was my grandmother's.
I know what you're up to.
Yeah, well, I don't blame you if you're mad.
How can I be mad? You're not sending me to Flint Rock Creek to hunt bullfrogs. You're sending me out to commune with nature, giving me the chance to contemplate our relationship and trusting me with your grandmother's bullfrog horn.
It's a bullfrog whistle. Listen, Claudine, you need to stop spending so much time thinking about us and concentrate on those bullfrogs.
Okay, well, let's see. It's an hour to the lake. Set your alarm for 5:30. You're having frog legs for breakfast, my sweet.
Put on Enter the Dragon, baby.
What else have you got?
Let's see. My cousin Elliot got rid of three wives with this one. Hey, man. Me and Nicolette rent the movie. You want to come up and check it out?
I'd love to, guys, but I can't tonight.
Malcolm, please. Look, I know Eddie and I aren't romantic anymore, but sitting on my couch watching a movie with the lights low, you know, he might forget.
I might.
Look, you two are just going to have to use restraint tonight. Claudine's on the way over here. See, I'm gonna make Simone jealous. That way she'll throw a crazy fit and get Claudine out of my bar and out of my life. You don't observe.
I'm thinking Fatal Attraction.
Yeah, I think you're right. It's gonna get ugly.
No, I mean the movie we should rent.
Hey, Simone. You know what? I need you to bring out a bottle of our best champagne and a couple of ounces of caviar.
Champagne? Caviar? What's the occasion?
Well, it's funny. You know how I took Claudine out so I could get a favor from Tim?
I'm still waiting for the funny part.
Oh, well, see, here's the funny part. I think I've actually developed feelings for her. And I want this evening to be special for her. See, there's your funny part. How do you feel about that, Simone?
Well, you're the boss. Champagne and caviar coming up.
Did I miss something? I mean, she didn't seem terribly jealous.
Oh, are you kidding? She's in the kitchen right now sharpening her shish kebab skewers.
All righty.
What a miss.
Tonight's special, shish kebabs.
Hi, Malcolm.
Oh, Claudine, my sweet. You look gorgeous tonight, but then again, you always do.
I know we can rent. Liar, liar.
Look, forget about it. This is better than any movie, and it's in 3D.
As long as there's no nudity.
Champagne.
Thank you, Simone.
Mm-hmm. Enjoy.
If you excuse me for a moment, Claudine, I have to go talk to my chef. How about that, Claudine? Brains, beauty, and she is absolutely, positively crazy about me. Sorry to be the one to break it to you.
Oh, no, Malcolm, it's better that it came from you. Excuse me.
Here it comes. Simone's a brown belt. Claudine doesn't even stand a chance.
Hey, 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 hey. Don't you hate when they tell the ending?
Here. Dr. Jeffrey Melman. He's my therapist. Now, he helped me get over Malcolm, and I think he could do the same for you.
Hey, Simone, what's the matter with you? When I don't want you to be jealous, you are. Now that I need you to be, you're not. Why can't you ever behave the way I want you to behave?
Malcolm, is there something that you need to say to me?
Yes, Claudine, there is. Listen, generally, when I break up with a woman, I call and leave a message on the answering machine. But with you, I went through a lot of trouble.
Wait a minute, we're breaking up?
Hey, Claudine, we were never together.
Oh, I get it. It's because I'm not a Victoria's Secret model, isn't it?
No, it has nothing to do with the way you look or the way you don't look. It's your smart mouth. You never give anybody a chance.
I gave you a chance.
No, you had no choice once I turned on the charm.
Oh, don't flatter yourself, Malcolm. That's all you turned on.
She's good. She should have been G.I. Jane.
Malcolm, I'm confused. What about the Cobra Club? What about the caviar and champagne? You certainly did come on awfully strong.
Yes, I did, but strong was wrong. Claudine, you are a challenge to be met. A mountain to be climbed. A research chemist to be toyed with for my own selfish purposes.
So wait, you're telling me that every woman you meet is simply for you to toy with?
No, not every woman. She has to be good looking.
You know what? I thought you were different, but you're not. You don't look at a woman and see a person, you see an opportunity. I feel sorry for you because you're not having relationships with other people. You're having an endless, empty relationship with yourself. Goodbye, Malcolm. My 5 senses aren't enough to take in all of that from you.
And they say there are no great roles for women anymore.
Kind of crashed him. and burn, didn't you, bro?
Burn. No, she stooped to wordplay. That's why I've always been leery of the smart ones.
That's what happens, man. When you start to live your life, you know, in the player mode all the time, you just can't turn it off.
No, no, see, that's where you're wrong. See, I know that there's some changes I need to make in my life, so from now on, I'm turning player mode off, and I'm keeping it off. And getting Al off of my shoulder is going to represent that.
Excuse me. Hi, I was wondering if you had any waitress positions available?
Well, not at the moment, but if you leave your name and number, I'd be happy to get back to you.
Alberta King. My friends call me Al.
I'll cancel the appointment at the skin doctor.
Now, are you sure?
Jaime.
Jaime?
Come here, here, take this for now. You know, because I don't know where the hell I am in the script.
Now, would you reconsider? The funeral home still has...